Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you made the universe with all its marvelous order, its atoms, worlds, and galaxies, and the infinite complexity of living creatures. Grant that, as we probe the mysteries of your creation, we may come to know you more truly and more surely fulfill our role in your eternal purpose. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom and
forever. Amen. Most High, Omnipotent, good Lord, grant your people grace to renounce gladly the vanities of this world, that following the way of Blessed Francis, we may, for love of you, delight in your whole creation with perfectness of joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Creeping things and wind birds. strength for his people and praise for all his loyal servants. The children of Israel, a people who are near him. Alleluia. 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 Come, let us sing, sing it to the Lord. Come, let us sing, sing it with our joy. Come, let us sing, sing it to the Lord. Come, let us sing, sing it with our joy.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Genesis. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things and wild animals of the earth of every kind." And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the air and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." God said, "See, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food." And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." The word of the Lord.
The children sang a song of creation and in our song,
Good morning, St. James's. And a special welcome to any of our furry or scaly friends who are with us today. We're so glad all of you are here. And thank you to the children's choir and the cherubs choir for uplifting this service with your beautiful voices. Thank you all. Thank you to our musicians over here as well. It's wonderful to have you here. So at the end of the service today, the clergy will come down to the chancel steps, and everyone is invited to come forward and have their pet blessed, or if you have a stuffed animal or even a picture of your pet on your phone, come forward and we'll say a special blessing and prayer and give thanks to God for all of the blessings that our pets give us. I would like to call your attention today to the beautiful stewardship reflection that is in your Sunday chimes from the Brinkley family. And please mark your calendar for October 28th, the Feast of St. James's. You should have gotten an invitation in the mail this week, but if you didn't, just call the office and we'll put you on the list. But do call and RSVP or send in your RSVP soon, because we do fill up at the Science Museum. It's always a wonderful occasion. And we are also taking volunteers. It takes a great number of volunteers to make that event such a success. So please look in your Sunday chimes for information on how to sign up. Next week, we get back to a little bit more of a normal schedule after kind of a wild and crazy September and early October. Sunday school, youth groups, confirmation class will all meet next week. Bible study with Tom Blair will meet today and next week and continuing. Next week, we will begin a new offering for young adults. This is an informal, casual conversation group for anyone, male, female, single, married, anyone in your early 20s to early 40s. We're just going to come and meet and talk about the issues that young adults are faced with. So come be a part of that. We will also have several short courses to offer beginning next week. The first one will be a book study on a wonderful book called Active Hope, which is about the environment, and Monica Lewis and some others from the Stewards of the Earth Committee will be leading that. And then we'll also have the news and the good news, a look at how our faith informs our understanding of current events. Let's see, we have a strategic planning online survey that you should know about, so please go online and fill that out before October 9th. And we also have paper copies available here in the Narthex. Next Sunday is our UTO in-gathering, so please read about that in your Sunday chimes and come prepared next week. Wednesday night, we've got lots of programs going on. Evening prayer in the chapel at 5:30, dinner at 6 o'clock, Pilgrim's Path, and then the third of John Kerr's offerings about science and religion at 7. We have a mission trip coming up, and it's a little bit last minute, but we have had a wonderful opportunity to go to Haiti and put the final finishing touches on the Wings of Hope building that our church has helped to build over many years now. So the dates are November 8th through 15th, and talk to Alan Stone if you are interested in going on that mission. It's going to be a wonderful, wonderful experience. I think that's enough for today. Please look in your Sunday chimes for all of the other announcements. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. As we lift before God those we love, and give to God those who are sick and those who are in need of remembering, we remember especially today John Calvin Barnard, Nellie Burrows, Whit Clement, Jenny Cohn, Grace Deagle, Violet Duke, Alexis Fira, Andre Green, Mimi Harrington, Suzanne Jackson, John Lingensfeller, Catherine Mock, Ford Molster, Jim Parkinson, Richard Rumble Sr., Brick Smith, Strother Smith, and Caroline Stalker. And we ask God's blessing on the marriages of Lauren Page Johnson and John Selman, and Ann Porter and David Prilliman, who were married yesterday. And we give God thanks for the birth of Michael William Wasso, son of Mary Catherine and David Wasso, and grandson of Taffy and Greg Williams. And for the birth of Mary Melville Marshall Bennett, daughter of Kate and Kent Bennett, and granddaughter of Andy and Dick Bennett, who were born recently. And on this St. Francis Day, we give thanks for the lives and ministries of those who celebrate their birthdays today. Betty Payne, Dora Ure, Scott Hetzer, Hayden Johnston, Dylan Callahan, and William Livingston, and all who celebrate their birthdays this week. We bless those pets who are here today and give God thanks for the blessings that they bring to us, for the comfort and the compassion, for the love and the support, the sweet cuddling and the challenge. We give thanks for all our pets, and we thank you, Lord God, and ask your blessing on those pets who are sick, especially for the cat Milo. And we pray for those who have departed. Bless thy holy name, O Lord, for all thy servants departed in this life in thy faith and fear, especially Shirley Shea DeJarnett, who died last week. For Mr. and Mrs. Herbert Worth Jackson, Jr., Ann Jackson Raglan, Herbert Worth Jackson III, Callan Ellis Caskey, and Mr. and Mrs. Robert Euclid Porter, in whose memory the flowers at the altar are given.
Blessed are you, Lord God, maker of all living creatures. You called forth fish in the sea, birds in the air, and animals on the land. You inspired Saint Francis to call all of them his brothers and sisters. We ask you to bless these pets. By the power of your love, enable them to live according to your plan. May we always praise you for all your beauty in creation. Blessed are you, Lord our God, in all your creatures. Amen.
Please turn in your hymnal,
love and serve the Lord, caring for all God's creatures.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah. servers and stuff.